Hello guys, this is TBC Production here. I'm doing a new video today for you guys. Before we get started with Chapter 3, let you guys know, when I uploaded all those videos that I had uploaded, all those videos that I worked on, because I have been busy, because I'm working and trying to work hourly with my schedule at my job and everything. Now, I'm not being on YouTube all the time. So I upload all those videos. I know the stop motion I did, Power Chucky, and the prologue story to Evil Thing, of course, chapter 1 and 2 is already uploaded as well. So I have to upload all those videos to character profile episode as well, I think. I'll upload all these videos so I can get uploaded and be on YouTube. Pretty soon, I really want to do a live stream pretty soon. I'll try to have guests, like, I guess I can go get Beat Dragon Ball Z or Star Blast or Silent Storm or Shane. Any of them. So we can do a discussion talking about such figure arts or something, you know, talk about something. So that's my hope, to do a live stream pretty soon and just keep sharing my channel and do all that stuff. It probably will turn into a podcast. That's what I probably will turn it into. So it's just been busy, and that's the only thing that has been going on. So anyway guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and check out the other videos if you haven't watched them. You know, I upload all those videos that same week and stuff, and that's why I tell you in this video. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the Evil Thing story so far. And actually, I went back and read the story. It's going to be 10 chapters instead of 20, so I knew I was wrong about that when I uploaded that video. I said 20, but it's actually 10. So let's get started with chapter 3. Let's go. Chapter 3. Good relationship. As I've been dating Gabriella, we actually had a good relationship. It's like we were married or something. We were going out on dates every single day. She makes sure I called her every single night. And it's been kind of nice. But at the same time, I was thinking it was kind of weird. Because as we've been dating for like 2 weeks, and that's how long I've been staying in California. So, even while I'm at work, it's like everywhere I go, she was there watching me, watching my every move. It's like she's always standing there watching. Even when I went to the bathroom, I walked out of the bathroom and there she was, standing right there. So I asked her, why are you watching me? I said. She said, I don't want you to talk to no one else. And I'm like, how I'm talking to someone else? And I'm not. I'm only talking to you. And the only thing she said, do you love me, Trey? And I said, yes, I do. But you don't have to be watching me every time. It's not like I'm going to cheat on you or anything. the only person I'm talking to. And after that, she walked away. But it was weird how she was watching me every move, every step. It just makes me think every time. It's like, every step I take, and every move I make, she was always there. Later that day, she decided that we should go out on a date again, as we've been dating every single day. This time, she wants me to take her somewhere, besides all the other times she was taking me. So, we went to this fancy restaurant. It was kind of almost expensive. It was all kind of like high class. She was actually very rich, because she's been working at the same job that I'm working at for 5 years. She was making a lot of good bucks. And this night, it was very a shock to me. She gave me $1,000. And I said, "Why are you giving me this?" Then, she said, "I love you, Trey. Do you love me?" And I said, "Yes, I do." It was a shock that she gave me $1,000. I thought I was dreaming at first. But it wasn't a dream. It was real. The food there was pretty good, but it was so expensive. After that, she dropped me off at my home. Because even though I can drive to the job, I didn't drive. She came to my house and got me and took me to the place. And she said, "Tomorrow after work, you should come to my house." So she gave me her address. And she said, "See you tomorrow." After I went for all the work, all day, I haven't seen her all day. She was, only time I seen her was in the afternoon, and when I got off of work. So, I drove to her house that she told me to come to. Her house was inside of a gate. Very, kind of like, almost like a celebrity. And I thought for a second, is she a celebrity or something? But when we got to the house, it was enormous and huge. And it was bigger than my house, even the house I was staying at in Seattle. It was enormous.